So, thank you for the introduction. This is Martin Oellers from the Institute for Microsensors, Actuators and Systems at the University of Berlin. And yeah, today I'm going to present to you the microfluidic swap structure to enhance on-chip liquid mixing. So that's the outline of my talk. So in microfluidics, we're dealing with low Reynolds numbers due to the small channel geometries and low flow rates. And you can see one example of a device where two liquids or two reagents are to be mixed with each other. And one possible idea is to create, as you see we're looking sidewise and on the mixing channel, layers of these two reagents. So we create layers of them, and mix them into one of these directly into a channel. Because of the vicinity of each of these reagents is very very close, the mixing here is pretty efficient. In this case, these inlets here are wedge shaped to compensate for the pressure drop along this distance, and before. This iteration was made of these wedge shape. The channels were actually rectangular, and the problem was that mixing at the sides was quite low. So there's always a lot of time that goes into redesigning these structures, fabricating them, because there are many fabrication steps that are included there. And we ask ourselves the question, how we can increase that or get a more universal platform. So if you think if we have a top view of a microchannel with a width of around 100 or the distance here of 100 micrometers, and we inject two liquids, as shown here, and we look at the diffusion time constant, it takes a very long time for one liquid to diffuse into the other because this distance here is very high, and we are in the range of seconds that it takes to diffuse if these liquids are not flowing, for example, and even worse. In this configuration, we have full two-dimensional control by optical lithography. And the question was now if we can use this as a platform and put some kind of structure directly into the microchannel so we can increase the vicinity of each of these liquids with each other, for example, go in the region of 2 micrometers, so the diffusion time constant reduces and the mixing vastly enhances. So there are a few methods. Probably all of you have seen nice contributions on 3D printed devices also at this conference. And for example, my colleague Friar Lucklum uses 3D phononic crystals with 3D printing. And if you use this stereolithographic additive manufacturing, you have a laser that shines light on the stage from the bottom, and you can write structures in an awkward fashion by illuminating every time a photosensitive layer, and create a structure like this. However, if we think about this channel structure we have, it's technologically it's not possible to use this technology for writing, and also the feature sizes are quite large. I mean, they're on the order of the size of the channel we have, or we cannot get down to these 2 micrometers actually. But another possibility is two-photon polymerization, where ultra-short laser pulses are used to focus light directly into a resin, and which are highly localized, and it's possible to create even sub-micrometer sized pieces of volume pieces called voxels. And then you can see that it is also possible to do structures in the micrometer range. So the idea was then that we have basically the standard fabrication process in microtechnology, which is photon lithography. It is wafer scale and it's really fast. If you have the spin code, and then you do your lithography and also the development afterwards. And on the other side, we have a precise and fast possibility to write structures, potentially write structures into this channel. And the nice thing is that we have full three-dimensional control over these designs by computer-aided design. And this is also commercially available in this two-fold on polymerization systems. So basically, we use the best of two worlds, where we make the larger or the basic structure, we make for photography, then we use this additive manufacturing to directly write these structures and then enhance the functionality of this microchannel by writing directly into it. So what was the idea? How we're going to enhance this this mixing of these two fluids? We came up with this swap mixer idea. So in the upper picture, you see we're looking with a fluid that's going along perpendicular to the channel. And you see these four channels. What is now to notice is that the liquid that goes along channel two is guided above channel three and exits at the position of channel three, and the same happens for channel three in a reverse fashion. You also might notice these bumps here at these sides, which are to compensate the flow rate for the adjust the flow rate so that the amount of liquid that goes through these channels is the same for each channel. Here in the lower picture, we can again see that actually channel two and three, they are completely separated by this element in the middle here, and one liquid goes above the other and the other one goes below. And this is really fast. It takes several 50 seconds for this structure, even less. And it is possible to implement these elements in these pre-patterned microchannels. So this is an optical picture of the structure we proposed. You can see here at the sides, when we're looking from the top, these are these bumps to adjust the amount of flow through the outer channels. And also here you see this curved surface where one liquid is going to the top and the other one. This also has been already implemented earlier, we proposed this curved design, and by increasing reducing the writing time, the complexity of our designs also can increase, and this allows also for new functionality of the device. So the fabrication process is quite straightforward. We lithographically define these channels in SU8 on a silicon wafer. Then there's this IPS resist that is directly placed at the position where we want the elements to be integrated, and then we use the Dibbin objective and directly focus into the channel and write the structure from the bottom. And we also create it's not shown in this graphic here, but we create an overlap at the sides of the between the structure and the sides of the channel, and finally we seal it with PDMS from the top and the contacted fluidity, and then measure the transport to the structure. So these are some pictures. These are some of the first trials. We can see that the element is well integrated within the channel, and it sticks really well to the edges of the SU8. And also with the when we look in SEM pictures, we can see that there's quite a robust adhesion between both materials. So it's actually really even if you if you try to get rid of it by blowing nitrogen on it or flushing the eye water through it, it really sticks quite well. So the one of the advantages is that when we use these CAD designs to directly print to the microchannel, we can integrate the CAD design directly into COMSOL and verify the functionality of this spot structure mix, of this mixer structure. And basically the outer channels, they're just, nothing should happen to them because we want them to be in direct contact with liquid A, for example. And it shows quite well that if we have in the in this picture, we see that from the left side, we have these two liquids that are coming in. One is dyed with a blue color, and the other one is just blue. And we see that even if we miss the edges a little bit, the functionality of the device it works really well. And what I forgot to mention is that the height of these bumps here in channels 1 and 4, we can reiterate that we can adjust the design, make a console simulation, look at how the flow rates through these channels are, and then we can optimize that. So the swap of these liquid portions can be reproduced. And as a small enhancement of that, this is the, if you remember the swap structure where we flip these two liquids, this can be seen here in the middle. And now if we repeat that several times, so if we do it in this stage and again in this stage, then we can really get, you cannot see it from this side probably quite well, but we can get down to these 2 micrometers, which I talked about earlier. And this is within a writing time of about a minute. And also the optical alignment, we see that is, we have made some progress. And here you can also see that it's quite well connected to the edges of the channel. And that I'd like to conclude. So we have shown that we have a fast embedding of 3D micro elements in pre-existing microfluidic channels, that is possible. And that the combination of photolithography and two-photon polymerization allows for complete systems in quite a short time. And that it's potentially feasible to decrease the mixing time by rearranging and splitting liquids in the microfluidic.